So lately with our rebuilds, we've been doing teams who have been to the biggest moments, but just haven't been able to get over the hump. Today, however, we're going to switch it up. We're going to do a realistic rebuild. Now, I don't know what to expect with Central Michigan. All I know is that on the poll, you guys voted them as the team you wanted rebuilt next. I have no idea why. But regardless, I think it'll be fun. I want to try it with a different approach. We know that the MAC teams start getting crazy good around season 4. So I want to see if we can keep up. I want to try and win 2 MAC conference championships. I don't know if a national championship will be possible in this rebuild, recruiting only pipeline and interested talent, but we'll see how it goes. You know what I might do? I might let us sign 1 Loloch Cheese player per year. So when we talk about first interest, what do we got? We got a center. Okay. He's probably going to go down overall. This is what I mean though. The talent isn't that great. We've got some 60s down here. I guess we're just going to have to get lucky with the 3 stars. Another 4 star center. He's going to go down though because his squat is not good. The O-line seems to be fine. We've already got 4 of those straight out the gate. The only problem is we're down in 4th interest already. So the best player that we would be able to get naturally would be a 73. I guess this is what the realistic rebuild is though. Seeing what we have to work with, we have Daniel Richardson, who's only a sophomore. That's fine. We got Lou Nichols. So we have 2 years after this initial year, and we still have a decent amount of players from that team. Might not be as bad as we think. We just kind of have to get lucky. So we're going to start off against Michigan. Is this going to be an annual thing? Because I don't like this. Oh, nice. We didn't even score a point. All right. So we get 1 Loloch Cheese member. Who is that going to be? I was hoping it was going to be somebody in the top 10. Like Landon Wilson was 17% last week. I was going to say take a wide receiver, but we don't even have anybody to throw it to him. There was a guy I saw at the top who looked like a really good cornerback. Myron Gold. We are going to rock with Myron Gold. 4'3", 240 as well. Nice. 79, we will take it. All right, so it looks like we got some decent signings. They're realistic signings, but I don't think we're doing very well. We are 1-7. It looks like we're going to get Myron Gold. Well, that's a 68 overall center. He's a 4-star though, so that's going to, you know, boost our class a little bit. We have 100 bonus compared to everybody else's like 340. I just really hope we are able to sign Myron Gold. Because if we don't get him, it's not like we can just go back and get another Loloch Cheese player. It's too late in the season for that. Okay, we finally got a win against Western Michigan. Georgia Southern, though, this is the game where pretty much every recruit is coming in. This has to be a win, bro. And it's a loss. Survey says we sign everybody but Myron Gold. Oh, no. Okay, we barely edge out LSU. Looks like everybody else kind of fell off a little bit. He is visiting LSU, though. Ooh, and that's in week 14, so that's this week. He committed to LSU. I mean, good for him, though. Realistically speaking, he should go to LSU because he's that good. It just means for us in our first year, we signed, what was it, 14 players? We got 14 players and none of them were really a standout. Not much to smile about. Daniel Richardson had 3,000 yards, 21 touchdowns and 13 interceptions. The rush game was not that great. The receiving game was pretty decent, actually. Both of our sophomore receivers, so that's perfect. And actually, defense was pretty good too. Roby Stewart with 6 sacks. Okay, well, we lose a grand total of 9 players. It's actually not that bad. So our first season, being realistic about it, where do we end up? 59th. We're ahead of UCLA. We're ahead of Georgia Tech. Okay, so who did the best in the MAC then? Kent State's above us. Okay, surprisingly, recruiting realistic, being realistic about it, we were actually 2nd in the conference. Kent State, like I said, was only 2 spots ahead. And the best part is we didn't even sign our Loloch Cheese player that we're allowed to get. And we still got 2nd. I'll be a lot more lenient this season as well. Tim Sanchez. This guy right out the gates looks amazing. We got ourselves a quarterback, running back, a guard. I can't believe I'm saying this, but if you're 60 overall plus, then we need you. Yeah, we're going to max out the board this season. This is great. This tight end looks really solid though. Brian Allen goes up to a 76 overall. He's not a JUCO, is he? He's not. He's genuinely a really good 3-star. Found ourselves a cornerback. This guy's almost as good as that Myron Gold guy. He's not a JUCO. He's a 3-star. How good is that? So we managed to find 2 players at skill positions that were almost 80 overall and they are 3-stars. There goes a 4th in Tim Sanchez. And not bad considering we started off against NC State. We lost by 14. Another really good opponent in Purdue. Forget all that though. This class is already looking way better than the last year's one. And it is time to find our Loloch Cheese player of season 2. 5-star athlete. Straight out the gate. My initial thought is that this is a running back or a wide receiver, but the 4-6 has me thinking this could be a quarterback. And we really need a quarterback. Yes, he is a quarterback. I knew it. He ran a 4-6. He just had to be. Survey says he goes up to a 79. We got the tight end, the cornerback, and the right tackle. So our three little three-star gems, all confirmed, all signed. We have an overwhelming lead on Chris Webb to start out as well. This couldn't be going any more perfect than it is right now. And there he goes right there, 79 overall. We'll definitely redshirt that quarterback. The current quarterback that we have, Richardson, he'll be entering his senior season. So this is a realistic rebuild. Realistically speaking, you're going to let that guy finish his senior season. Blake Corum just won his second Heisman in a row. All right, so our security is low. I'm surprised we have not been fired yet. But it looks like Daniel Richardson stepped it up. Last year, he had 3,000 yards. This year, he has 3,700. 23 touchdowns and 16 picks. So it begs the question, what is really going on here? Rushing him was decent. Lou Nichols did a lot on not that many carries. 5.6 average, good for him. Receiving in, Dallas Dixon had 1,200 yards. Really good. Defensively, not bad at all. We even had somebody over 100 tackles. No, our quarterback is leaving. He noticed that we signed like 7 cornerbacks and he's out of here. So far, 2 years in, I gotta say, a realistic rebuild is actually a lot of fun. So we did get the top class in conference this year around, and that is going to be a top 25. 19 3-stars, 1 5-star. In fact, you know what? I'll redshirt every freshman we just signed. We did get those 3 really nice players, one of them being Charles Williams. We definitely want him at his best. By that means, we just gotta redshirt every cornerback we get. All right, so we at least have the groundwork done. Right tackle, cornerback. Oh, the punter. Even the punter is 77. My goodness. We have 4 more seasons to recruit. I don't think we're going to actually recruit all 4 seasons, to be honest with you guys. We're going to finish out this team as realistic as possible. One thing I will say, though, is we have not gotten a lot of defensive linemen or linebackers. So even though they're more than likely going to be absolutely trash, kind of have to pick them up. Not bad at all. 33 players this time around. Being a lot more lenient definitely helped. Like, I didn't think the 3-stars were worth really going after. If anything, this rebuild is showing me different. Matt Tootin, interesting name. He's going to go up to a 76. He's a gem. Trey Crenshaw, he's an athlete. Look at that excel. Wow, so this guy is a wide receiver, running back, and he can play safety and corner. Kind of can do it all out here. We beat Oklahoma State. Okay, I haven't checked our overall or anything like that because I didn't think we were very good. That is a lot of team needs. Outside linebacker, of course. We already knew that, though, and D-line. Quite literally, the 2 things I emphasized is exactly what we need. Oh, it is week 3, though. Okay, it's Lulok Cheese week. Who's our 1 player going to be? We have a 5-star athlete again in the top 10. I'm going to go out on a limb and say Antonio Butler because he runs a 4.48. So there's way more of a chance that we're going to get, you know, a wide receiver out of this, something like that. And we just got Chris Webb, so we kind of want a target for him to throw it to. 85 route running, 83 CIT. 83 catching. So he's a wide receiver. That's perfect, though. That's exactly what we need. So we are B pluses across the board. But that's really, really good. No wonder we were able to upset Oklahoma State being 90 overall. Not bad at all. There goes all the mid to high 70s right there. We even broke a school record there. Not bad. So if you guys didn't see my community post the other day, I have a custom team on the way. It should be here any minute. I'm not sure when I'm actually going to release it yet, but we are going to add Feng's recruiting mod in for that. I know a lot of you guys have asked me to do it without rebuilds. If you don't know what it is, it basically just makes recruiting a lot more realistic, and there's no real cap to how good players can be. So it adds a lot more depth to recruiting. That is going to be it for season 3, though. There's nothing really else to do. We're 6-2 as well, so we will get a bowl game. We might even end the season ranked at this rate. You know what I'm just thinking about now? Is it even realistic that we got 2 5-stars in 2 years? So they were ranked 99th overall. They signed pretty much nothing but 3-stars. I'm going to go out on a limb and say that no 5-star is going to go to Central Michigan. Not to shit on them, I promise you. But I might not get any more Lulok Cheese players. In fact, if I could go back, I wouldn't even sign the wide receiver we got. We do finish the season ranked. Daniel Richardson for his final season, 4,100 yards, 39 touchdowns, and 17 picks. Jordan Williams, who will be back this senior season, had 1,500 yards and 12 touchdowns. Blocking was somewhat decent, and defense, again. Sack numbers are up there, but look at Dante Kent. 9 interceptions. That's nearly one a game. What a beast. I think this year we're going to lose a lot of players, though. Just a hunch. Bro, if you're not going to start here, you're not going to start at A&M. I promise you that much. And finally, we can scroll down. Wow, that is a lot of players. Daniel Richardson is not going to the draft. So again, that was a top class in conference. We're 34th this time around. We got 17 3-stars, 1 5-star. This might be the last year of recruiting that we do. 94 wide receiver, looking nice. It's a decent team. We have quite a few high 80s. I do really need to get some O linemen this year. It just pretty much boosts up the team. The only problem is every year, what I've noticed is that we're averaging about 3 to 4 mid 70 players that we find as 3-star gem. And I don't really have a lot of control as to if the 3-stars are good. We are not low lock cheesing this year though. Okay, so there's a bunch of linebackers to start out. Look at that. We got 5 of them in first interest. 4-star quarterback, genuinely interested. I will pick him up because I feel like they would pick him up in real life as well. And we got a 4-star wide receiver. Another 4-star tackle. Might be a little bit difficult to get this guy, but that is a top 50 recruit right there. We have rank 1 Ohio State and we have Oklahoma State again. Dude, there's no way we make a natty if this is going to be our schedule every year. Just want to get a little bit of a reference. Last season, we were B pluses across the board. This year, we're only Bs. We're an 86 overall. Toledo is ranked 21. They're also 86 overall. NIU is 90. Okay, the MAC is no joke. Everybody seems to have leveled up big time. Okay, nice. We got Carlton Carter. We'll take that. We're not really getting too lucky here, unfortunately. Wow, look at all those arrows, huh? It wasn't even that bad. 25-42. We are competing with, like, the best teams in the nation. We got locked out by Blankenship and Richards, though. This is what I was worried about. We have to keep an eye out here, though, because we almost just lost the one prospect we need the most, especially since we're not low lock cheesing it this year either. Definitely need to get Blankenship here. Lucky we didn't bring him in there because we got pumped. 24-66. Beat NIU. That's a big time matchup. Okay, we got the lead. That pretty much is going to round out the class. So there's not really much we can do. It's not bad. I mean, it's pretty bad to be fair. Beat Toledo though. They were ranked in everything. The toughest team in our conference. And we got a big dub. We're still in a recruiting battle. So we have not been locked out yet. You know what? Just go to the end of the season. Whatever happens, happens. So in season 1, his very first season, he is going to break the passing touchdowns for a season record. He actually broke Richardson's record. If that isn't a good sign, I don't know what is. Let's check out these stats though. Chris Webb, first season, 4,200 yards, 45 touchdowns, 13 picks. Wow. Averaged 322 yards per game on 52%. If he can just up that percentage, we're big chilling. On the rushing end, not bad at all. Remember, we are emphasizing the pass game, 1,300 yards for Jordan Williams. Top 3 receivers are all leaving this year. Blocking is somewhat decent, and defensively, that is a lot of sacks for Jonah Pace. My only fear is that, like a lot of teams in the MAC, after the 4th year, they drop off quite a bit, and that is definitely going to happen to us. So Jordan Williams is going to go ejected in round 3, and that is a lot of players. Like I was saying, these guys are all mid to high 80s as well. All right, so we're behind by 1,400. Let's just go all in. And we got him. So we played it perfectly. We again got the top class in conference. And again, we didn't low-lock cheese it. So that's the 34th best class. We're up to a 3-star. We got 2 4-stars. But remember, those 4-stars were genuinely interested in us. There's a lot of players that we didn't get as well. Woo! Okay. That is a lot of linebackers. Checking our training results. So Chris Webb up to a 91 as a sophomore. So he is guaranteed to be a 99 that final season. Yeah, I mean, this is a really, really solid. What about our wide receiver as well? So Antonio Butler's up to an 85. So he'll probably be around a 95 his final season. It's really, really good. That'll give our quarterback a really good target. But there's only 2 more seasons of recruiting left. See what the computer can do this year. There's nothing more realistic than the computer taking over. All we need is a tackle. What's our schedule looking like though? Kansas again. And they gave us Tennessee. I mean, they're not ranked, but again, that is 3 Power 5 teams in our first 3 games of the season. Oh yeah, and just give us Texas A&M as well. Because why not, right? Every out-of-conference game we have is Power 5. And it's pretty much been like that every season too. Wow, okay, the computer did their thing. 79 running back, 77 guard, another running back, and a wide receiver. Chris Webber is going to go ahead and break yet again another record. B. Allen, I don't know who that is, but he's broken like 3 or 4 records as well, so we're going to have to investigate. However, we did throw the third most yards in the nation, so 4,200 yards, 37 touchdowns, 12 picks. Was that better or worse than the last season? I think it might have been worse. Regardless, really, really solid from Chris Webb. We like it. He scrambled for 679 yards, so he completely took over the ground game too. He said, fluff the running backs, I'm taking the ball. Receiving end, Brian Allen, the tight end. He's an All-American. He had 2,000 yards. Mateo had 1,100. Not bad at all. Blocking was actually decent, apart from Tim Sanchez. He let in more sacks than he got pancakes. Sacks wasn't that great. Stephen Blanchard was the only saving grace. He had 6 interceptions. Not bad at all. So even though we dropped down to a 2-star prestige, that was the 17th best class. The computer managed to sign a 5-star. Ooh, I don't know about realistic with that one. They got 3 4-stars and 1 5-star. Looking at the team, I reckon we will by far still be one of the best teams in the MAC. Chris Webb as a junior is up to 97. It's very rare to see a 97 as a junior. Butler's up to a 90. So we are going to have that target. Not bad. We are better than Michigan State to start this season. B plus, A minus offense. We also have some All-Americans that I want to give their due. Chris Webb is the All-NCAA first team quarterback. Brian Allen is the All-NCAA first team tight end. Anybody else? Oh, Blanchard. Blanchard, who will be there that final year too, is the All-NCAA cornerback. Regardless, let's see how we do. We start off with a win. Oh, there we go. We are ranked. So second place in terms of yards had about 4,000 yards. We put up 5,200, 58 touchdowns and 9 picks. So it's very easy to see why we won the Heisman. Antonio Butler, who again will be returning next year, put up 1,900. Brian Allen, our trusty tight end, with 1,500. It's really just these three. It's Butler, Allen, and Chris Webb. I don't even know if anybody on the team is really doing anything, to be completely honest. No disrespect. Chris Mackey, who's only a 78, put up 10 sacks. Wow. This might be the strategy that we go with for any rebuild from here on out. But the realistic method seems to be way better because it's not guaranteed that we're just going to dominate. Like, Chris Webb is a 99. We have a 96 free safety. The team is good, but it's not overly broken. It's not OP. We don't have players that we shouldn't have like we do when we low lock cheese it. So if you take away Butler and Chris Webb, we're pretty much stuck with not a great team. You know what I mean? Again, it's going to be 3 Power 5 teams, 1 non-Power 5, but they're ranked. Like I said, I never thought we were going to win a natty, but we did get our first Mac. So we are, wow. Okay, so Auburn's B plus, we're A plus and A minus. So our offense is absolutely stacked. So like Western Michigan, 77. Everybody's like 79. So everybody pretty much fell off. There's only 2 teams above 80 overall, and they're not even in our division. We are 95, 99, 92. So we should absolutely whitewash our entire conference. We just got to get through Auburn, Illinois, BC, and Boise, and then we'll see what's going on. Okay, starting off with a pretty big win there. At 6-0, I want to see if we're ranked, because we should be. If everything goes as planned, we're pretty much going to be 12-0. Kind of crazy when you think about it. Why wouldn't we lose to Ball State by 1 point? So we are still going to be ranked. Very interesting. So we're down to 23. We were ranked 9. So if we had just won that game, which we should have, we're definitely going to be top 5 by this point. But no. Again, I have to emphasize, we have scored over 100 points in 2 weeks. That would have to jump us up the rankings quite a bit. We are, geez, ranked 17. So yeah, unfortunately for us, I don't think we're going to recover from that singular loss. And to be fair, I completely agree. If you are this good and you're expected to go to the natty, blah blah blah, there goes 63 again, by the way. So that's 189 points in 3 weeks. Just want to see how we did. We're a coach of the year finalist. We make the conference championship again. This realistic rebuild, doing really, really well. I did not expect us to be doing this well. We're gonna win our second MAC championship. So I said we're probably not gonna win a natty. I just want to win a couple MACOs. We're probably going to draw a top 10 matchup, I would hope. That would be a really cool way to end this. Let's have a gee, shout. We finished second. Wow, this guy in first dominated. You know what? Just have it, bro. So Drew Gold had 3,400 yards, 35 touchdowns, 3 picks on 67%. We had 5,400 yards, 61 touchdowns, 6 interceptions on 74%. So there is no universe where Chris Webb shouldn't have won the Heisman, but the game just decided to cuck us, essentially. You, in fact, have 4 of the 6 records. The only one that we still have not got is by Cooper Rush on the receiving end. Butler, he has 3 records of his own. He's right there next to Antonio Brown. Kent has 2 of the interception records. That's really nice. For our stats, 5,400, 61 and 6. Just insane numbers from Chris Webb. He definitely got robbed there. He also scrambled for 600 and 12 touchdowns. So now that I'm looking at this rushing stats on top of the passing ones, I'm genuinely angry. Receiving in though, 3 receivers over 1,000 yards. That's a perfect way to send out Antonio Butler and Brian Allen as well. Blocking was decent. I don't know what Jason Williams' problem is, but there's always some guy who's not playing well. Blanchard again, 5 interceptions. Hopefully he gets himself drafted. So if I'm not mistaken, everybody should be starting out hot, which they are. Look at that. Ah, look at this play. This is sick. Bro, it wouldn't let me click on. I know I didn't start us off great, but I want to see how we bounce back. It looks like we scored instantly. Look at this. Oh, they're going to turn it over. Nice. This was really close, and especially considering I messed up the team to start. Nice little cheeky juke in there. My closing thoughts are, I must say, I really do like the idea of the realistic rebuild much better, you know? We can't cheese it, and whilst, you know, we can guarantee results by cheesing it, it just seems more fun. Central Michigan is a team who probably won't be in the top 10 in the next 5 years. I wouldn't imagine so, at least. But by restricting ourselves and still managing to be in the top 10, only missing out on the Natty by 1 game, gives these rebuilds more life, more opportunities. Instead of just having 780 overalls in one class, you know, you really begin to value those 74s, 75s, 77s, things like that. But yes, fellas, if you did make it this far into the video, then you are the real MVP. Hope the rest of your day is awesome. And from me personally, I'm out. Peace. Sometimes I wonder, can I breathe right underwater? Sometimes I wonder, can I speak in outer space? Sometimes I wonder, can I call upon the thunder? Sometimes I wonder, can I make